Most of the time, when we describe what's happening within the atmosphere vis-a-vis atmospheric pressure, what we do is we describe one of the two fundamental types of pressure systems. These are, first of all, low pressure systems or low pressure, which technically, scientifically, would be known as a cyclone or a cyclonic system, and high pressure, which again, technically, scientifically, is known as an anticyclone or an anticyclonic system. Let's look at this diagram on the right-hand side, and I will describe it for you. With high pressure, first of all, also known as an anticyclone, high pressure is indicated on a map with a capital H for high pressure. And if you look at what's happening, take a look where you have that capital H, this is what's going on. From very far aloft, aloft is spelled A-L-O-F-T. It means very high up in the atmosphere. From very far aloft, the air descends, which means it subsides, it diverges, and in the northern hemisphere, it circulates in a clockwise direction. So take a look, you can see that the arrows are indicating that the air here is descending and it's diverging. You can see that, okay? You can't see the circulation yet, but you have to trust me, in the northern hemisphere, the air would be circulating in a clockwise direction. And notice you can see this, the sun, and the sky is clear because high pressure systems are associated with clear skies and dry air. Now look over at the right-hand side. You can see we have a different diagram. With low pressure, also known as a cyclonic system or a cyclone, we indicate a low pressure system with a capital L for low pressure on a map. And with low pressure, the air converges, which means it comes together, it rises, and it circulates in the northern hemisphere in a counterclockwise direction. Take a look, you can see this, that the air is indeed coming like this and like this. So from the right and the left, and converging right in here, and then rising. And then notice that low pressure systems are associated with clouds. Clouds are associated with precipitation. Okay. Now take a look at these two diagrams, and you can see on the left-hand side, we have a high pressure system, and notice the air is descending, coming down, and then in the northern hemisphere, the air is circulating clockwise. Then over here, we can see that we have a counterclockwise circulation going around the low pressure system, and the air is rising. Okay, excellent. So, on this planet, there are what are known as the global pressure belts. These are certain areas that are under the influence of particular pressure systems throughout the year. So, in other words, throughout the year, they experience either high pressure almost every day of the year or low pressure almost every day of the year. If an area is dominated by low pressure, based on what I just told you, what would you expect? Would you expect that area to be wet or dry? You over there, answer. Good. Wet. And if it's wet, would you expect that area to be a heavily vegetated or a not very vegetated area? Answer is heavily vegetated. Excellent. Whereas if an area is dominated by high pressure throughout the year, what would you expect? The air to be what, or the area to be wet or dry? Correct. Dry. And so would you expect that area to be heavily vegetated or not very vegetated? The answer is not very vegetated. Excellent. So let's take a look at this map. This shows you the global pressure belts on Earth. So let's go through them. First of all, notice this. Centered on the equator at 0 degrees is what's known as the equatorial low. Everything you'd expect with low pressure is happening there. Converging, rising air, clouds forming, precipitation falling. It should be no surprise that the great tropical rainforests on Earth are located there. Then notice, we have at 30 degrees north and 30 degrees south, centered on those areas. These things really stretch over about 10 degrees of latitude. So, in other words, they'd be going from 25 to 35 degrees in both hemispheres. And you can see I circled in the northern hemisphere this area in yellow, and in the southern hemisphere in blue. That will be the consistent way you're going to see them from this point on. So, centered on 30 degrees north and south, we have what's known as the subtropical highs, the northern and southern subtropical highs. Everything you'd expect with high pressure is happening there, descending, diverging air, clear blue skies, and it should be no surprise that the great deserts of the world generally line up right in there. Then notice, that at 60 degrees north and south, we have an area of low pressure. These are called the northern and southern subpolar lows. And everything you'd expect with low pressure is happening there: converging rising air, clouds forming, precipitation falling. Although this is very far north and south, so it's very cold. And as a result of that, a lot of the precipitation will be falling as snow. And we have dense needle leaf forests in these areas, not so much in the southern hemisphere because there's not a lot of land there, but in the northern hemisphere. And then at 90 degrees north and south, we have the polar highs. So these are the northern and southern polar highs. Everything you'd expect with high pressures happening there, which is descending, diverging air, clear blue skies. Take one more look. There they are.